Baby, baby, baby. What's up, good people, aka winners? That's what we do, ay, that's all we do, ay. I'm coming to you with another video, ay, coming to you with another video. Ficky, ay. What is up, good people? C-Key here, okay, because I haven't said that in a long time. But this video is super duper, like, dope to me because, first of all, you guys know that I love talking about new products. I love talking about foundation reviews, product reviews, all that good stuff. I absolutely love it. But I also love, like, videos where I can talk to you guys about existing products that you already have, right? To teach you guys how to get the best out of the products that you already have, okay? Or possibly teach you how to, so that's about it. Wait, because I was about to say the same thing, but it was gonna be the same thing in a different way. So pretty basically, I'm gonna show you guys some makeup hacks. And so I was like, being that, you know, we can't really go too many places, I was like, now what can I do to assist my good friends here on the tube? And I'm like, makeup hacks on stuff that you already have. Like, let's say you cannot make it out to get your favorite liner, right? And I know, like, some shipping has slowed down or whatever. So I have a trick for you. And I already did it though, low key, okay? And listen, let's just, like, I don't know what is happening in my life right here, but we're just gonna act like it's not there. Okay. Plus it'll be gone in a second. But what I did, you guys, was I made my own liquid liner look. Bam. And I even had the nerve to do a little wing. Okay. So I wanted to bring a little happiness in your life to show you guys that you could work with what you already have and you don't have to try to run to the store just in case they're closed. Okay. I made this liquid liner with two products and I actually left mine on my makeup palette to show you that it was real, because if I were to try to do this on camera, y'all know I already have a video on how I apply liner and I already tell you guys that I do not put on my liner the YouTuber way. The YouTuber way is, let me show you something. This is the YouTuber way, okay? It's taking a liner, taking one hand, and just boom. That's not my testimony. That is not my life situation. When your girl puts on liner, she has to, like, I need two fingers or two hands. It's a must, okay? So I was not about to do that because I need to be all up in the mirror. What you will need to do this, I mean, hopefully you have a makeup spatula. If you don't, use something that you can work with that will get the job done, okay? This is Makeup Geeks Corrupt down there, okay? And I'm gonna dig into it because, like, since I've been doing makeup, I don't think that there's ever a time that I hit pan on a black eyeshadow. So I totally don't mind, like, kind of digging into it. And I really didn't dig. I kind of just scraped off the top layer and put it on my palette. So I just took some of that black eyeshadow and I did it like so. Oh. First of all, I wasn't trying to get you guys all up in my nose. Second of all, I wasn't trying to blow air on it and make some of it fall. And then what I did, you can also try this with setting spray, okay? But I'm not gonna use setting spray. I'm actually gonna use this MAC mixing medium. Now, this is really, really great when you want to put on eyeshadow or glitter or just any kind of eyeshadow, really. Well, not matte eyeshadow, but if you wanna do, like, foiled eyeshadow or you wanna do glitter eyeshadow, it's really, really good to lay this down first and let it get a little tacky and then apply your eyeshadow. That will keep your eyeshadow in place and it will stop it from transferring to your upper lid, especially if you have hooded eyes, okay? I used a little bit of this, and you want to do a little bit at a time because, let me see if I can come up here. You want to do a little bit at a time, and I don't put it directly on the eyeshadow. I just put it on the side, and I began to scrape a little bit as I needed it. So basically, it looks like that, and you just keep rubbing it until it gets really creamy. Now, you can try this with setting spray, but the reason I like the mixed medium is because it makes it more of a creamy substance instead of, like, a real liquidy substance. However, the reason I say setting spray is because I don't know if you guys remember, but I did a photo shoot with ColourPop, right? And I had a makeup artist. I will show you the video on the photo shoot because I did some behind the scenes. But my makeup artist, she actually did my brows, and she did my brows with eyeshadow mixed with a little bit of setting spray, and that is how she came up with the brows. Now, we already know I'm gonna just put it out there that I have a love thing, okay? And just life is not complete without my Ofra, what is it? I don't even always look at the name, but it's semi-permanent eyebrow gel and it's dark brown. This is the new packaging that they have. So that is definitely what's on my brows, but can it be done? And can you make your own pomade or, can you make your own pomade? You certainly can, but I wasn't doing that on today, okay? This is what your eyeliner will look like. And what I did, let me wipe off this spatula because that eyeshadow will definitely, it'll kind of stick. So I don't want it to stay there. All right. So what I did, and let me close my mixing medium. What I did was I used a brush. This is actually a Real Technique brush. I don't know where I got it from. If I got it from Ulta or wherever, I'm not even sure. It could have been sent to me. I don't know. But it is, gosh, I don't even know what the name of it is. It just says eyeliner brush, but the key is using something very stiff because you want to apply your liner. And I had the nerve to do a wing, girl. We got a little wing out of that. I was shocked, but everyone doesn't always do a wing. So it's great for if you just want to put a little like tight line or something like that, or put a little liner at the top of that lash line. This will work really good. So if you ever run out of liner, never fear. Like eyeshadow and... what is this? Mixing medium is here. Okay. Bars. And so you can use something like that, or you can actually use an eyeliner brush. And this one is, it's a pointy eyeliner brush and it is a Morphe M443. And these I actually use on clients when I'm doing their brows or when I'm doing their liner. But I think the next hack, I'm going to show you correctors. Now, the crazy thing is I have shown you guys some of these hacks before, but I did it in the midst of another video. And so I never really broke down a whole full-fledged video on just straight up like makeup hacks, which I thought it would be dopeness. So dopeness. Pause for the cause. Do you guys notice anything different about me? Look at these claws. Y'all know I do not do nails this long and I don't know what to do with myself. I think in like a couple weeks, you're gonna see me with my short ones. Cause I don't know. How do y'all type and stuff? Like girl. So this is going to be my hack on making a corrector. And so I'm taking this corrector. Now, depending on how like deep your dark spots are, if they are like so dark that they're like a really, really deep, deep, deep purple or a deep, deep, deep dark, whatever kind of color they are, okay, then you may want to go into this and use this. Like some people actually use red lipstick and they just go straight out the tube, or they just go straight from the corrector and they apply it. My darkness is not that serious, so I don't really use anything that deep, because if I use it that deep, then I'm gonna have to work hard to actually cover it up with my foundation, and that's we're not trying to do that, right? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna mix it with my foundation and I am going to make my own customized color corrector. This is the corrector that I usually use. It has a hint of orange to it, but it's a concealer, but I use it as a corrector. It is Makeup Forever number 51, but I am almost out and this is probably like my third one. So actually let's leave that here as a guide. And so what I did was I mixed my foundation. That was the Urban Decay Stay Naked. The number of this one is 70YW, and I simply mix that with that LA Girl Orange corrector. Get a little closer. That's close enough. I'm not gonna like keep adding foundation because I can definitely work with that. But if you want to make it a little bit lighter and take some of that orange out, you can definitely do that. So now all I'm gonna do is I usually correct around my mouth. I just can work with this. I like mine lighter, but this is fine. I can work with it. And the whole thing is we're gonna put foundation on top of it anyway. But if I were using this and I just wanted to put powder on top, like my everyday makeup look I showed you guys, yeah, no, I would need to go a little bit lighter because that orange would definitely come through. So I'm just gonna put a little under here. I don't know if you guys can see that on camera, like all that's giving me under there. See that? Like it's a little bit of darkness under there. And I don't like that. Like if I'm gonna do makeup, we're gonna do makeup. So that's another hack for you. This one is not necessarily a hack, but it is more of a tip. So this is a concealer tip, but we are gonna get to another hack. I have one. This is the Juvia's Place number 12, and I'm using this as a highlight. putting it under my eye and a little bit further, okay? I never go right into the crease. I blend up with the sponge, and I'm going to let this sit here. The reason I let it sit here is I let it dry a little bit, because as I let it dry, it stays in place better. Now, do I do highlighting in that crease area and my forehead and all that? No, for the simple fact that I have a line like right here, because like I be having serious conversations and I'm really into it. And yeah, so I have a little line right there. And if I highlight there, baby, it just accentuates that area. So when we highlight, we're highlighting the areas that we want to stand out or be accentuated or pop, if you will. And usually what I use is this Morphe Showman's Bronzer Palette right here. And this is what I contour with. But you don't always have to like pack all these different things. First of all, you can use this as a travel hack too, to minimize all of the products that you're packing when you're on the go, all right? So you could just take this palette and you can say, okay, now what color is really, really close to the contour in this palette? And it's pretty much like this one right here, right there, okay? So I'm just gonna go into that one without digging, I don't know how y'all do it, the nail, okay? So I'm gonna go into that one and I'm gonna put my brush in there and I'm gonna use this, I don't wanna put too much, and I'm gonna use this as a contour. Like I'm using eyeshadow to contour with. Let's take this Morphe 3502 palette, and then I'm gonna, because I don't even like my nose contour that heavy. So I'm gonna go into this, oh, see, nails, help me, help, help. I'm gonna go into this color Rich right here, and I'm gonna use that for my nose. And so this just goes to show you, like you can use that for that nose contour as well. All right, so the next hack is eyeshadow again, okay? Follow me here. And I use this one a whole lot. I've actually done this in makeup looks and I've told you guys about it. So it is this color, right? I don't even know. Let me see. It is called Hunts, and it is from the, like this palette has received a lot of love from me, cause it's really a love thing. And you can see the dents in there, huh? You can see it. You can see it. So this is my favorite one to use as a blush, and that's Hunts. And I know it's coming off like really, really orange, but I promise it's not. So just take that, just like that. And then I just apply it as a blush. I love that as a blush and blend it out. So I am going to use my Ofra Beverly Hills palette that I've beat up so much. But this right here is, it's actually called the All Glowed Up palette. But I love this Beverly Hills little circle here, this little palette. It's, you can get it separate like that too. I will put the link. And if you use the code CKEY, you can actually get a discount. But this is my favorite shade. And so I'm just gonna put this on, this is like totally my highlighter brush. Don't judge me, because yes, I did use it. So I use it for that, but you can also use your highlighter as an eyeshadow. So you can literally take it, give you a little bit right there. See that? It just gives you a little lift and it gives you a little shimmer, shimmer. And you can also take it with a different brush, I would prefer, but you can put some right in there, right? To open up your eyes a little bit. You totally can do that with the highlighter. And even if you wanted, you could take it and just kind of put it on the lid, and it acts as an eyeshadow. That wasn't the look I was going for. I totally did that for y'all. Like that's all in love. And I just, you don't even have to get all fancy with it, just boom. This is the final hack, okay? So that sponge where you got all that foundation, I wish I still had some on my hand, but the sponge where you had all that foundation, put it on your lips. And this mutes out any discoloration. This will not only make your lipstick pop from, well, let me rephrase that. Not only will it make your lipstick pop, but it will show the lipstick's true color, because most of us have either pink lips, dark lips. Some of us have like kind of red lips, right? And so this will actually mute out all that discoloration. And naturally, this is like your skin tone if you have the right foundation color, right? If you have a darker bullet lipstick, this is what we call a bullet lipstick because it looks like a bullet, right? So the pointy tip on this lipstick, if it's a darker color, you can literally turn it, flip it like this, and then make it as a liner if you do not have a lip liner pencil of preference, okay? So you can do that. You can actually use a lipstick bullet. That's what I do. And I'll just use two colors. And so in this case, I do have a lip liner, so I'm just gonna do a little bit, cause I really just wanted an outline. I didn't want it to be too dark. So that's that foundation. And I showed this in another video too. I'll link that as well. And then you take a clear lip gloss or a lip gloss with glitter. Now me, I'm gonna put it on my hand because I cannot stand, listen y'all, don't walk around here using that, and if you are gonna use the doe foot applicator, like use it and wipe it off. When you put it back into there, it's grody. We don't wanna do that, that's nasty. Just no judging, but just, I'm trying to help you, okay, sis? And so then you take your gloss. I just gave you a new lip for free. And so that is the final hack look. This is y'all's fault because I was not trying to do that with the eyes. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back into that color Rich that I used for the that I used for my nose. And I'm just going to take it right here and put a little bit there. Since y'all done made me go there with the highlight, we're just going to step this eye look up a little more. Wait. Okay, I forgot to tell you the gloss. The gloss is actually Ofra Luminous Lips, baby. And I think I told you guys everything else, but just know, it'll be in the description box, okay? Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Thank you guys so much for hanging out with me. Please share the video, okay? I would appreciate that. That helps the channel out a lot. Liking it helps it out more than you know. Have an awesome, blessed day, and I will see you sooner than you think. Bye.
Confidence is key. You know what I mean. A woman feels good when she's looking pretty. Yeah.